Hi, this video is a whirlwind tour of Visual Studio productivity with dotNET. Now we have full-length, hour-long tours of all of this, so I'm just going to see how many features I can cram into, hopefully less than 5 minutes. Let's dive in. First is Visual Studio Search, or Control Q. Here I can find what keyboard bindings I can set in Visual Studio. We've recently added Resharper in Visual Studio Code, so you don't have to break your muscle memory. You can also search for kind of obscure options in Tools Options using Control Q. So this is me easily looking up code style. Speaking of easy navigation, Control T is our GoToWell navigation. So you can easily view recent documents and you get to see a preview of them. You can also navigate to file types, members, symbol declarations. Speaking of navigation, use Shift F12 to open Find All References. You can filter Find All References to only read and write references. You can also use Go to Definition or Control Click. And you can always navigate backward using Control Minus. Next, you can peak definition with Alt F12. You can always run tests with Control RT or use the Code Lens icons. In the Test Explorer, you can easily filter tests to only failed tests, for example, with the new filter buttons. You can also completely organize your group by and hierarchy to whatever you want. So now it's organized by project namespace and class. So let's dive into some code fixes. Notice at the top of my file, I don't have a newtonsoft.json reference. Visual Studio can now add missing usings for a block of copy and pasted code. So now, when I accept that code fix, newtonsoft.json was added to the top of my file. I can also get completions for types that I don't have imported using completion for unimported types in my IntelliSense list, and it will automatically add that reference at the top of my document. Another refactoring is add null check. Again, all of these refactorings are accessed through control dot. Next, I have an invert and if else statement. Just ways to easily refactor your code so it looks the way you want it to. Let's say I'm re-architecting my solution and dragging and dropping files into new folders. I can easily sync my namespace with control dot. I can also extract an interface to the same file. So this is for when I have a type, but I actually want to use it in many different places. I want to go ahead and extract an interface. If I didn't promote all of the members to be a part of that interface, I can actually pull a member up at any time. Now, I have some pretty inconsistent code style and use of var versus explicit type throughout my files. I can easily enforce code style using editor config, which is a file that will live at the root of my project. So if I go ahead and search for the var rules, I can select all of these with next matching caret or shift alt dot. And I can change the severity from silent to give me an error. So now when I go back to my code editor, I will get red squiggles where I could be using the explicit type. And I can clean up all of these at once using code cleanup or control KE. So that was navigating, refactoring, testing, and cleaning up your code. Thanks for watching the whirlwind tour of Visual Studio productivity.